get there.
As long as it comes out okay, it comes out. that how it feels about the birthday? Or?
Well, her birthday is tomorrow.
I'll listen to it. didn't abandon you, but by the parents.
I know. That's your first duty. Yeah.
And this is just for this. So she has to tear it down.
Thank you.
All day, without a doubt, I'm going to ask you to be honest.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning.
Beautiful.
Can we all take our seats and listen to the composition composed by her daughter Cuckoo for her mother, and she has dedicated that. So could we all take our seats and prayerfully listen to this beautiful song written by her daughter for her mom. Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank all of you for coming this morning, getting up early in the morning to honor our beautiful Amma. She was precious to all of us, and she lived a beautiful life. She always told me, I can do nothing apart from him. He guided me, he led me, he cared for me. He was my husband, he was my father, he was my brother, he was my friend. And today, I thank her for leaving that legacy to us, a legacy that money cannot buy. It's just all her children are blessed, and they follow in the footsteps that she has left behind them. So today is a day we have come to praise God and thank him for a beautiful lady. She was very precious to us, not only her children, her in-laws, but she was grandchildren and great-grandchildren. She taught us much through her songs, through her wisdom, through her knowledge and words. And we want to praise and thank God for lending this beautiful lady, Amma, to us for 99 years. But Amma would say, no, I'm 100 years old, because she said the first birthday is when you finish your first year. So on her 99th birthday, she would have told me, Pulla, it's not 99, but 100 years old. So we thank God for the century that he has given. Let her live with us. Thank you, Father. And he was so gracious, because we were all on Tuesday night, her children, we were all standing around her, and we were singing and praying. We sang Amazing Grace, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, Blessed Assurance. But finally we started singing Safe in the Arms of Jesus. It was God's grace when we sang Safe in the Arms of Jesus. She slipped beautifully into his arms. So today we celebrate her life, praising and thanking God for a beautiful lady, a precious lady, whom we all love so much. Can we bow our heads in silence for a minute and say our own prayers? Loving Father, we come before you this morning with grateful hearts to thank you and praise you for a beautiful life that Ambi led and for the beautiful legacy she has left behind. She depended on you and you never let her down. She brought up 6 children, Father, with your guidance and with your strength. For this we thank you and praise you. Today I pray for a special peace, a peace that passeth all understanding, a peace that you promised us before you left this earth. You said, my peace I give unto you, my peace I leave with you, not as the world giveth give I unto you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let it be afraid. For lo, I will be with you always. You will never leave us nor forsake us. So we thank you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
பரிசுத்தமுள்ள அன்பின் பரலோக பிதாவே, இந்த அருமையான அம்மா அவருடைய வாழ்க்கையை நாங்கள் நினைத்து நமக்கு நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். அவருடைய பிள்ளைகள், அவருடைய பிற பிள்ளைகள் ஒவ்வொருவருக்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். அந்த கிரேட் சேலஞ்ச் இன் அவர் லைஃப், அவங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கை அவ்வளோ ஒரு முன்மாதிரியாக இந்த பூமியில் இருக்க கர்த்தர் செய்த கிருபைக்காக நன்றி. இதில் பங்கு கொள்ள கொடுத்த எல்லா சுவாக்கியத்துக்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். உங்களுடைய ஆத்மா உங்களுடைய நித்திய பரலோக வீட்டில் வந்திருக்கத்தக்கதாக கர்த்தர் அவர்கள் செய்திருக்கிற கிருபைக்காக உமக்கு நாங்கள் நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். அவருடைய பாடல்கள், அவருடைய வாழ்க்கை முறைகள், அவருடைய எளிதான ஒரு முன்மாதிரியான நடத்தைகள் இந்த தமிழ் உலகத்திற்கும் இந்த குடும்பத்திற்கும் பல திருச்சபையில் வந்திருக்கிற எங்கள் ஒவ்வொருவருக்கும் ஒரு முன்மாதிரியாக இருக்கிறமைக்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். இந்த அருமையான இந்த விழாவிலே பரலோகம் எப்படி மோசேனுடைய அடக்கத்திலையும் தேவையில் இருந்தது போல நம்முடைய பிரசன்னம் அங்கே இருக்கிறமைக்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். தொடர்ந்து இந்த அடக்காராதனையும் கருத்து ஆசீர்வதியும் உயிர்த்தெழுகிற மகிமையான நாளிலே இந்த அம்மாவை நாங்கள் பரலோகத்தில் சந்திப்போம் என்ற விசுவாசத்திற்காக நாங்கள் நமக்கு நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். தொடர்ந்து நம்முடைய கிருபையான பிரசன்னம் வந்திருக்கிற ஒவ்வொருவர் மேலும் இருக்கட்டும். நம்முடைய அன்பும் நம்முடைய கிருபையும் இந்த இடத்துல வெளிப்பட ஒருவரை ஒருவர் பார்த்து உண்மை மகிமைப்படுத்த இந்த அம்மாவனுடைய வாழ்க்கை எவ்வளோ ஒரு சாட்சியாக இருந்தது. அவருடைய பிள்ளைகள் இசைகளிலும் கல்விகளிலும் ஞானங்களிலும் பண்புகளிலும் ஒழுக்கங்களிலும் எவ்வளவு சிறந்திருக்கிறதை பார்க்கும்போது அவர்களுடைய ஜபமும் அர்ப்பணிப்பும் எவ்வளவாக நிலை பெற்றிருக்கிறது என்பதை அறிந்து உமக்கு நாங்கள் நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். பல தேசங்களிலிருந்து வந்தாலும் கலாச்சாரத்தோடு ஒழுக்கத்தோடு இருக்கிற இந்த அருமையான குடும்பங்களையும் வந்திருக்கிற ஒவ்வொருவர்களையும் நாங்கள் ஆசீர்வதிக்கிறோம். தொடர்ந்து நீர் மகிமடையும் எங்கள் உயிர்த்தெழுந்த இரட்சகர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து மூலமாய் ஜெபிக்கிறோம் எங்கள் அன்பின் பரலோக பிதாவே. ஆமென், ஆமென்.
Dying, Christ destroyed our death. Rising, Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory. As in baptism, Christina put on Christ, so in Christ, as Christina be clothed with glory.
Please stand.
We are God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. But we know that when he appears, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. Those who have this hope purify themselves as Christ is pure. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. The first and the last, I died, and behold, I'm alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you will live also. Dear family and friends, we have gathered here this morning to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate with joy the life of Christina Raja Duray. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace, that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow hope, in the death resurrection.
Thank you.
may be seated. Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, we praise you for all that you do for us. And this morning we praise you for Christina, whom you have taken home to glory. We ask that your Holy Spirit will be with us here now to grant us that peace and comfort that transcends all understanding. And eternal God, we praise you for all the company of those who have finished their course in faith and who now rest from their labor. We praise you for those dear to us whom we name in our hearts before you. Especially now, we praise you for Christina, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To all of these, grant your peace. Let perpetual light shine upon them and help us so to believe where we have not seen, that your presence may lead us through our years and bring us at last with them into the joy of your home, not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now, please join me, and you may remain seated as we sing Because He Lives, number 364.
Thank you. of John's Gospel. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper to be with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You will know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Yet in a little while, the world will see me no more, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. In that day, you will know that I am in the Father, and you in me, and I in you. These things I have spoken to you while I am still with you. But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. This is the word of the Lord. Let us pray. Gracious and heavenly God, we just again thank you for the light of Christina. And as we briefly reflect on your word, may you bring comfort and that peace that passes all understanding. Amen. I've shared with you from the 14th chapter of John's Gospel, and in this Gospel, Jesus is speaking to his disciples. Jesus would soon be going to his death, but he speaks these words to them so when the events happen, they can see through eyes of faith and not despair. In our life, we are exposed to many adversities and troubles, but what this passage teaches us is though we cannot prevent these things, God does not leave us alone. He has sent us the Holy Spirit to be with us, and also when we are with Jesus, we know we are not alone. It was the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Trinity, and it's that peace that passes all understanding, that strength to get through the days ahead. I only have had the pleasure of knowing Christina for a year. I went to her 98th birthday. And I remember she was sleeping, but even then she gave me a kiss. It was a woman full of love and joy. And as I've gotten to know so many of the family members and that are still active in our church here, it is clear that the love of Jesus that she has and internalized has gone on and to be passed on to her family. And so Christina knew that the Lord was with her, and as we will miss her, she is now in heaven celebrating and singing, and all this talent, Michael, I had no idea. And so, but it's just such a blessing, and I know that she would be so proud of everyone here. When I visited her the other day, I read a passage from Psalm 91, and I did not realize it, but it was her favorite psalm. So I just want to share a couple of verses from that. And it seemed to really kind of talk about who she really was and what got her strength through the years, which her grandchildren and great-grandchildren will be sharing with you momentarily. But I read with you these few verses. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone. You will tread upon the lion and the adder. The young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Those who love me I will deliver. I will protect those who know my name. When they call to me, I will answer them. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation. And God clearly granted her a long and beautiful life. And she was a sweet soul full of joy. But still, even with 99 years, we are still at a loss because your loved one is now not physically with us anymore. But may you be comforted by the fact that she is now restorative health and strength in heaven. In 2 Corinthians 4:16 to 18, we hear these words. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. We do not die in a sense, but our bodies are changed, we are transitioned. And now Christina is at home. For us here, it's a loss. But take those things that you love about her, those things that inspire you about her, and reach out to others in kindness and mercy, because that way her legacy is carried on, and it will never, ever die. She had the blessing of being surrounded by a loving and adoring family, and what a blessing that is. And may each one of us share love in that way to others. In a few moments, the next passage that a family member will share comes from 2 Timothy 4:7. But I would just like to share with you verses 6 to 8, because the Apostle Paul is soon going to go to his death. And he's speaking to his protege, Timothy, and tells him these words. For I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time has come for my departure. I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. I know that Christina has certainly earned her crown, and I know it has many jewels in it. She lived a wonderful life and had strength and was an inspiration and touched so many lives. And I'm certain that when she arrived in heaven, God said, well done, good and faithful servant. And may God surround and bless each one of you now. And I close with this image. It's one of my favorite images of a clipper ship. I spent many years in the Hudson Valley, and often during the year, they'd have the tall ships and you'd watch them leave the shore and they disappear. But did they disappear? No, they just landed on another shore. So I'm sharing you a poem called In Voyage by Carlisle Emery. There's a ship sailing on to a harbor, to a haven of comfort and rest. It's a ship of God's fashion and making, and its voyage by him will be blessed. It departed with silence and beauty, with the master himself in command. As with dignity truly majestic, it sailed out of sight of all the land. There will always be clear skies above it. There will always be calmness below. There will never be storms to harass it, for the master is on it, you know. And his wisdom will carry it safely to a port of his infinite peace, where the light of his love will protect it with a blessing that never will cease. You have watched it sail onward and outward with a tear of regret in your eye, for a loved one was sailing upon it, and there's grief when you're saying goodbye. But your tears would be tears of rejoicing, and your heart would be happy and free if you could look for only a moment on that ship sailing out to sea. For the one you have loved is at leisure, with no worry or trouble or care. There's contentment beyond understanding in the way God's passengers fare. And you know from your own observation that the sailing was joyful, not grim, for it means a new life and new living, in a sweet closer contact with him. Oh, the solace there is in the knowledge, life is life and it always will be. And it's simply a change in direction on that ship sailing out to sea. And the tears that we shed for our loved ones are in truth shed for us left behind. For it hurts to give up to the master, though we know he is gentle and kind. So believe in his good and great wisdom. Trust in him as you patiently wait on the ship God is ever a pilot, and the one you have loved is the mate. Let us pray. Gracious God, we ask that you will be with us this morning and surround us with your love, and we thank you for the life of Christina. Amen. And now the family will share with you. Thank you.
And what a grandmother she was to all of us. Few people have lived and persevered with true adversity. And I know only one among me who overcame that adversity so triumphantly. My grandmother, Amelie. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. How did Amelie run this race? Only by her courageous, unyielding, unwavering faith in God. Trusting Him at every turn in life. True faith, something I aspire to gain myself. I know some call her Christina, others Abama, but I fondly call her Ambi. I wish I could take credit for engendering that name, but I have to honor my brother Dinesh, my oldest brother, for truncating Abama into Ambi. She was born August 31st, 1918, and from all the stories I've come to know, led a life that would otherwise be considered normal, getting married at the age of 20 and having her first son in 1939. My grandparents built a family of six by the time Ambi was 37. That is when tragedy struck the family, and my grandfather left to be with the Lord in 1955. Ambi was left a widow with six children, 15, 7, 5, 2, and baby mommy was only 1 month old. Did she falter? Did she flee? Did she fail? No, she prevailed and was undaunted in the face of her life's perils of trying to feed, clothe, and raise six children by herself, but with God by her side. She did so through praising His name and trusting each decision was not hers, but in fact, it was His. She sacrificed all she had to raise her children and worked by the sweat of her brow from sunrise sundown. Ambi used the arts to cope with the insurmountable task she had every morning when she rose. For her music and poetry were the gifts God gave her to cope with her life's uphill battles. I must say, I did my part in helping Ambi maintain her faith when she moved to the U.S. I can clearly remember taking her out to our cottage in Derby on an inflatable boat. We went on the river, Pixotonic, and to make the boat ride more exciting, I rocked the boat to and fro. Well, Ambi wanted to stand up, and an inflatable boat, it did not work so well. And so needless to say, there were yards of sorry material soaked after we capsized. How she swam in a sorry, I am still baffled. That is incredible. But she always referred to that as her second baptism. Full immersion, I'll tell you. I can remember each birthday, she would illustrate and compose a unique card for me. She would outline my name in a different color, and a poem was created, starting with each line with each letter of my name. She used her artistic license to make even the most mischievous of her grandchildren sound like an angel. Ambi expressed her feelings of isolation and despondency all the way to joy and elation through her writing and her musical compositions. She knew this was her gift from God, which allowed her to make it through and overcome her life's trials and tribulations. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day. So it is time, my dear Ambi, to receive that crown and take your rest you so dearly deserve. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 9. Do your best to come to me quickly. It took her 99 years, but she made sure everything was done just right before she decided to go. You've done more for your family and your life than you can possibly fathom. Having sacrificed to educate your children, not just scholastically and teaching them how to work diligently and have such a work ethic, but most importantly, teaching them values to love each other, to bring the family and to be together. These lessons shall pass down to generations present and also the generations to come. Now, we, your ever grateful grandchildren, celebrate your life and show our love and appreciation for our grandmother by the songs that we have chosen that have touched our lives. I would like to introduce my cousin Nelson to say a few words and start our celebration of Christina Rodriguez, our beloved grandmother.
Thanks, Amen. I think he wrapped up Amama's life beautifully. Many of you guys know who Amama was. And even when she goes, I think she's going to be doing her work there. And Jesus might be like, okay, you already did 99 years. Relax, it's okay. You know it's going to happen. My name is Nelson. Many of you know my mother, Cuckoo. You know, she's sitting in front. Other people know her as Navarajini Jayaraja. Basically, I'm going to read out a statement what my mom has written in honor of her. And I want to share the story about a song she wrote, Visvasa Kappal. And I want to share her words, so everything is written what she wanted to say. For many who know Visvasa Kappal, in Tamil, you guys understand the meaning, but people who do not understand it, the language of Tamil, which is very, very hard, and I'm always good at it, they're going to translate on the screen in English. And it is going to be a boat rocking, and when you read the verses, you will actually understand what it is. So I would like you folks to concentrate, to focus on the video itself, and it will set the tone of what the song actually really meant. Songs are not mere words. They have a story behind them. When I was very young, either 6 or 7 years old, I remember my art teacher asking the class to draw something that was very special to us. I would draw a ship on a great ocean, traveling on a dark and gloomy day. I still remember my teacher asking, "Why is it dark and gloomy? Why don't you make it bright and sunny, like normal people would do?" The answer lies in the vision that I saw after our dad passed away and we moved back to Sri Lanka from Malaysia. In the vision that I saw was an endless ocean with my beautiful mother in a gray sari holding on to the 5 of us and a newborn baby in our hand. She was crying out, "How can I cross this vast ocean?" There was a great lightning and thunder, and suddenly there was a voice from heaven saying, "You are not alone. I will be there with you." Many years after I saw that vision, I began working with the missionary, Mr. Don Rubesh, from the Back to the Bible Broadcasting Corporation. My mother inspired me through faith and works of worship to our mighty Heavenly Father. Her life was an example of 1 Timothy 1:19, which reads, "Holding on to faith and a good conscience, which some have rejected and so suffered shipwreck with regard to the faith." It was with that verse that brought me back to that vision of many years ago. My mother was the faithful ship with unwavering faith, even in the storms of her life. Shortly after I composed my very first song, Visvasa Kappal, which became a favorite to many, it was a story of my mother, a 37-year-old widow, who became the sole provider of 6 children, ages 15, 7, 5, 4, 2, and a month-old baby. She transitioned from a gentle wife into a lone warrior and crossed the ocean to begin a life of sacrifice. Her only comfort was God's providence. She would tell all her children that even though you don't have an earthly father, you have one mighty Heavenly Father who will take care of you, come what may. I will miss the greatest blessing and inspiration that God gave me to call mother. She will never be replaced. For all that I am, I owe to my angel mother.
Thank you.
governed by God's house. Ava, Christian, Aubrey, Cole, and Lil Winston.
Thank you.
7 minutes, she used to cook in the kitchen. And she used to make the children, especially my mom, sing this song. And it was recorded in the late 60s at the back of the Bible. And 10 years ago, Grandma felt that this song wasn't complete. Because she, you know, she was always a person who wants to do everything perfectly. The last verse was written 10 years ago, and the English meaning to that is what I'm going to read now. As my soul reaches to the heavenly shore, the fellowship once again with my Lord, for joy and peace fills my heart, knowing that I will live with my Lord Jesus forever. introduce my sister, Anne.
So this song that I'm going to sing is a special request from all of our lost children. They would like to dedicate the song to an amazing mother who was their true angel here on earth.
Thank you.
feel
wonderful in all your ways. A friend, mother, for all astray. Your courage, like a fire glows, and heals the broken soul. You're clothed with strength and dignity, with words so peaceful and kind. Oh, the eyes of the dove, filled with empathy, rich in love, humility.
And just briefly on all this love I want to expound upon. Her love for me was steadfast, true, it was authentic, and it was consistent. I think that, so I'm a Christian. As a Christian, I do believe that all humans are going to fall short of God's standard of love. He's the only one who can perfectly love. And that's because there's an absolute divide between us as humans and then the infinite God that never started, has always existed. There was no start point to God. That's what separates us. However, Amama, in her 99 years, had a very steadfast love for me. And I know others, but I want to speak to me, how I view it. It was a very steadfast love. And, I've known that for 30 years about her. She's done that three times as long, more than that. She was always concerned about my well-being, my moral character, my education, my development, my maturity into a man. She's very, very cognizant of, very repetitive on how she wanted me to grow. She's always saying, I want you to be this kind of man. And as I age, and her birthday cards would change, and they would talk more and more to my age. She was always concerned, consistently concerned. I think she wanted more from me on the piano and violin, and my brother picked up that slack. But I'm not removed, or if not removed, she increased the limits of what I saw a human is capable of in terms of love, patience. She had a sacrificial love. In fact, John 15:13 says, Jesus himself says that the ultimate expression of love is to lay down one's life for another. I don't have any doubt that this lady would have done that. And I think, in closing here, I think Amama would want nothing more than me to just briefly touch upon what her faith was as a Christian. If anybody knew anything about Amama, everyone knew her solid knowledge of Scripture. She would know verses hidden away. She would know them, but she didn't have to refer to the Scripture. She knew music. She knew Christian history. I don't know how she did it. As you've heard before, six kids, single mother. And yet she had a strong knowledge that takes time. But I think, Amama definitely, she knew that believing a Christian, it meant believing in Christ. You've heard my auntie earlier today mention that Jesus will open his arms to us. It's Jesus that separates us from any other religion, or separates Christians from any other religion. As I mentioned before, God's standard for salvation is he's an infinite God. And us as finite humans can never achieve what it's going to take to appease God. And that's what divides us from God. That's why he is God and we are not. And I just, ask yourself to think about this. If there was any other way for us to be saved, whether through works or denial of fleshly pursuits, if there was any other way, why would he have sent his son to die for us? If there was any other way, the Son of God. So I think, with that, Amama and I spent some time. My brother was there, my sister-in-law was there, and her vision was going, and her hearing was going, my auntie was there, and we were like yelling at her, trying to see if she could hear us, and holding up pieces of paper. And what she said is that Christ was her Savior. And I've heard today how much that meant to her, what Christ meant to her. For her to make a song about it, as Nelson said, the song is not just a song, it's deep, it's feelings. I'm just glad that Amama's love for Christ flowed to my mother. My mother also loved Christ and what he did for us. And I thank God for his providence. So I just say, last statement here is Isaiah 54:10. It's about God's love. It says, for the mountains may be taken away and the hills may be moved out of their places, but my love will not be taken from you, or my agreement of peace broken, says the Lord, who has had mercy on you. Amama was a beacon of love. She will be missed, but I have hope I will see her again.
As the Reverend read about a half hour ago. share with you a few words about Amma and how she touched our lives, or was it a story that she shared with us, or a story that somebody else shared with us, so that you know what she meant to us.
Many know she was very steady, right? And well, I'm going to apologize because in case we didn't get much chance to practice, because she didn't give enough time, right? She didn't let me know. Because if I'm off key or something, you know, Grandma might actually even open the cupboard and point at me and be like, "That's some off key," right? Because she's very, very accurate in what she does. And many who actually saw the sari she actually wore for a funeral, her own funeral, was picked in, when she was 8 years old. So in reality, she always prepped us for 19 more years, right? But we just didn't want to accept it. And she's an amazing grandmother, right? Because like he said, the amount of information she has, she's one of those, you know, the people who know iPhones, and she's that 256 gigs, you know, there's so much of data that's going in that little room that she can. She's amazing. Love you, Grandma.
I tried to run the story through
Rocco
before I said it, because I feel like it's a little bit inappropriate. But, I mean, it's what I laugh. It made me laugh, and it, you know, it was sincere, deep laugh. But you know, I'm the one who visit, you know, Dad's and Mom's house, and she would come by. And, I don't know, actually, age or whatever. But you know, it's just like
he doesn't.
Yeah, thanks. Good morning. It's just, you know, she would let these noises come out, right? So it's just so hilarious because she'd be sitting in the kitchen, and for whatever reason, it would be hilarious, and. Brother would be this, I don't know, it's sincere.
It's the blessing.
So, what I would like to share with you guys is one of my favorite stories about Amma. I've written it down in case I thought I would be teary-eyed, so I'm going to read it. So, this was shared with me several years ago. When Amma immigrated to the United States, she wanted to become a citizen, so she prepared for a citizenship interview. The day arrived, and Amma, being the traditional woman, wore a sari to the interview. You can just picture, right? It's the United States interview room, and everyone's like all dressed in suits and skirt and gloves, and Amma walks into the sari. And I can just picture the officer looking at Amma and saying, "I hope this woman can talk to me in English. Like, how else am I going to do the interview?" And so the officer bids her to come into the room, and he says, "Christian, would you take a seat?" And she does take a seat, and his first question to her was, "Christina, have you seen the White House?" Her reply, "Officer, do you mean a White House or the White House?" Yeah, she was spectacular that way. She was a woman of great faith, integrity, and sacrifice who exemplified Jesus' teaching to treat your neighbor as yourself. That was her.
I'm Amma's favorite grandchild.
Oh.
So I'm usually a naughty one, and I remember, you know, when I was a little child, Amma made chippies, and she gave me a couple, and then I said, "I want more." She said, "Oh, no more, you know, you have dinner." So I got angry and I chased her around the room. And then later, my dad chased me around the room.
We all knew that she had a very musical ear, so if you were ever playing the piano and she upset you, all you had to do was play it.
that key and you got hit, right? And if you really want to do it, you kept doing it and you said, I hit your flat, okay? Otherwise, what you do around her is you had that posture. She was very strict about that. She was a man, she always carried herself. And you know, they used to call me say walker. The other thing that I think really got her was we all knew Grandma loved Bill Clinton. The man could go, no fault. So if you ever really wanted to get her, you'd be like, Grandma, what do you think about Monica Lewinsky? She was one of the, you know, we have relatives who we kind of embarrassed to show other people. She was someone I was very proud to say that was my grandmother. And what I loved about her was she thought outside the box. She did not accept dogma. She always made me challenge things. And so I was a, I think I was like a 13-year-old kid. I was a teenager, insecure with the way I looked. So, you know, I was tall, very lanky and gangly. And I came up to Grandma and said, Grandma, you know, I'm so grateful for the genes, you know, you made me, you know, smart people, we're good with music, but why does Shrunkins have such skinny legs? And she looked at me, she lifted up the sari a little bit, she looked at me, and she goes, so you're telling me you look a little bit like an ostrich? And I was like, yes, something like that. And you'd like to look a little bit more like a hippo? I was like, yeah, I think it's pretty good. She kind of goes, so what is a more elegant creature? I was like, an ostrich. And she goes, what can run faster? I was like, the ostrich. And she goes, what can jump higher? And I was like, the ostrich. And she goes, why do you want to be a hippo? So, Grandma, thank you for everything, and thank you for the chicken pies.
You're good? Yep. Alright. I'll say the best for last, right? I think I was very fortunate out of all my cousins because I had my grandmother with me through my formative years. I assume it's because I'm her favorite. And you know, that definitely, you know, good things and bad things. You know, my grandmother loved making those Sri Lankan treats, and I think part of the reason I looked like a hobbit is because she fed me like a hobbit. You know, five times a day, kukri, bombay toast, whatever I wanted. I think one of the stories that sticks with me, or let me put it this way, just kind of not just a story, just an overwhelming thing that I feel, is, you know, my grandmother was my roommate for a long time, both blessed and cursed. And I would tell you that you would think that with my father being a banker, that, you know, I would have learned about money, finances, goods, services through him. But no, I would have to say it was from my grandmother first. And I apologize for the butchered Tamil. But, you know, as my roommate, you know, at the end of the day, Grandma would say, Nambi, thank you. Yes, this way, okay, I speak English. And basically, it turns out she's like, you know, little guy, my back hurts. And so I was the back massager for grandma. And in exchange, she would tell me stories. And it would just go on for years. And what I found out was, hey, I'm not very good at back massager, so if anyone needs one. It's been a couple years. But as the years have gone through with, you know, this exchange, I realized that after a while, I was on telling the stories while giving Grandma a massage. So not only was she the first one to teach me about goods and services and trading, she was also the first person to, like, scam me. So,
thank you.
feel humbled by the presence of all of you. And I know there are more stories, and I'm sure others would love to hear more too, but what a wonderful legacy. Something for all of us to aspire to, so thank you so much. It's really wonderful in these days to hear so many young people share how God means so much to you. God of all of us, your love never ends. When all else fails, you are still God. We pray to you and for one another in our need, and for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. To all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. In all our ways we trust you. And to you, with your church on earth and in heaven, we offer you honor and glory now and forever. Amen. O God, all that you have given us is yours. As you gave Christina to us, we now give Christina back to you. Receive Christina into the arms of your mercy. Raise Christina up with all your people. Receive us also and raise us to a new life. Help us so to love and serve you in this world, that we too may enter into your joy in the world to come. Amen.
Amen.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your daughter Christina. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive Christina into the arms of your mercy and into that blessed rest of everlasting peace and into the glorious company of all the saints of light. Amen. Again in prayer, God of love, we thank you for all with which you have blessed us even to this day, for the gift of joy in days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise in days of pain and grief. We praise you for home and friends, and for our baptism and place in your church, with all who have faithfully lived and died. Above all else, we thank you for Jesus, who knew our griefs, who died our death, and who rose for our sake, and who now lives and prays for us. So as he taught us, now let us pray together. Our Father,
thank you.
understand and to keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Have you decided to walk there?
My soul.